Co. If this is your first time watching, my name is Leslie Holt, and I am the host of This Square. Now, if this is the first video that you are seeing, welcome to the interactive corner. The segment before this was the informative corner, and what I did there, or what I do here, is I take a bunch of things that we interact with daily or things that we do daily, and I talk about how they affect our health, our mental, emotional, physical, and spiritual health. The informative corner, I spoke about my knowledge upon those topics. Here in the interactive corner, I brought on guests who their profession may deal with that factor, or they deal with that factor on their own, and they were able to share their knowledge to give you and I both more of an understanding of how that does affect our health. But today, switching up the format, as you can see, I'm here alone. That's because today's topic is solitude, and who better to accompany me in this video than myself, right? So, solitude. I feel like the year 2019 was meant for me to be alone, was meant for me to grow alone, do things alone, you know. At the end of 2018, that's all I talked about was like, I need to be in my own space. I need to be in my own head. I didn't know why. And I didn't know how I was gonna grow, but I knew that me being alone was going to help me grow in the direction that I needed to. So here comes 2019, you know, I get what I wish for. I got my own space. I'm doing the groundwork to get better. I began reading. I began praying a lot. I began meditating, doing yoga, you know, creating the space for me to grow. I was learning the tools, at the time I felt like I was applying them, but now looking back at the past few months, I can say that I was not. Beginning of 2019, I was doing all the groundwork, and mind you, it was the winter, the spring, so it was easier to isolate myself and to distance myself from others. Here comes summer, you know. Who doesn't love to kick it during the summer? I, you know, was taking trips, kicking it with my friends, and I began to become distracted again. I began to pull myself from my initial goal that I had set for being alone. What happened? Oh, 2019, I turned 25. my birthday is in August, so the end of the summer. After my 25th birthday, I felt like the dust settled. And I always knew that everything that I did, everything that I wanted, everything that I needed always depended upon me. But after my 25th birthday, it just felt, something felt different. I felt like from here on out, everything mattered more than it did ever. Everything that I did, everything that I said, everything that I felt, everything that I allowed to happen, it mattered more now than ever. My face is really greasy, excuse me, it's shea butter. But, so after my 25th birthday, reality set in, and I feel like I fell down again. I lost hope. I was wallowing in sadness and self-pity because I knew that I wasn't happy going about things the way that I was going. I wasn't happy with my work-life balance. I wasn't happy with, you know, the relationships that I was trying to pursue. I just knew that things weren't right. I knew that things weren't right, and I knew that things were going to get better, and I knew that I was stuck in a rut. But when you're stuck, your first instinct should be to get up and get yourself better, but when you're in the process of healing, it doesn't always happen like that. So like I said, I knew that this wasn't the end. I knew I had a plan. And this is something else. Something that I retweeted on Twitter a while ago. It said, trust your gut. And now I finally have an understanding as to why that saying is true. Everything in the stomach correlates with the mind. So when your gut feeling is telling you that something is not right, that's your mind telling you like, yo, hey, listen to me. I know, you know, that's your intuition. Your gut is your intuition. So trust your gut, basically. But like I said, I always knew that I had a plan. And I knew that I wasn't going to be down for long. I knew I wasn't going to be stuck for long. I knew I wasn't going to be sad for long. But at the time, I just felt, you know, I had lost hope. I wasn't eating. You know, I hadn't been talking to my friends like I was. I fell back into a dark space. But now it's November. Looking back on the past few months, looking back even towards the beginning of the year, I think that I came to an understanding, a conclusion as to why I needed to be alone, why I was wishing these things about myself last year around this time. In order for me to be the big person that I knew that I was always meant to be, I had to change certain factors about myself. I had to grow in certain areas of my life. And I wouldn't have been able to do that. I could not do that in the presence of others. I could not do that with others always expressing their opinions and feelings to me, because the energy, you know, it was the I'm on the path of healing. And if you're not on that same path, your energy can distort mine. Your frequency can lower mine. And I didn't know why at the time, but I knew that I needed to just get up out of here. So the past few months, like I said, I've been really down. Beginning of November, I feel like I had awakened again. And I wrote this note to myself. Just, you know, saying how the past few months have been really hard. I've been, you know, wondering, questioning, praying, crying, just doing a lot. And I finally understand that my spirit has been on a search. My soul has been on a search for alignment and fulfillment here on earth. These thoughts would have never crossed my mind had I been seeking advice and help from others. You know, I have me. When nobody else is around, I have to look to myself for answers. I have to look to myself for help. So these past couple months, that's what I have been doing, or that's what I had been trying to do. That's what I am still doing, and that's what I feel like is right. That's what I know is right for me, you know? But the past couple months, I started to pinpoint the areas in myself that I needed to grow in and the aspects that I needed to change. Self-love, patience, faith, balance are all major components when you are trying to become your higher self, when you're trying to become your best self. Those are attributes that I struggle with, that I still struggle with, but I feel myself getting stronger in them, you know? I don't know. Like all morning, the past couple of days actually, but this morning especially, I've been wanting to cry. And not because I'm sad, but because I'm happy. And like I said, I have been reading, and I now know and I now feel that I understand that crying isn't always a bad thing. When you're crying, you're expressing an emotion. You're releasing tension. You're getting something out. You're leaving something behind. So me wanting to cry this morning is like, I feel like it's because I'm waking up. I'm shedding that layer of, you know, of pity. I'm shedding that layer of sadness. I'm shedding that layer of loneliness. And I'm shedding I'm shedding that layer of me feeling lost. I'm shedding that layer of me, you know, losing faith. I'm uplifting. I'm new. I feel like I've rinsed myself of all of those feelings that I have been feeling the past few months, you know? And that's when self-love. I'm learning that I'm smart, I'm passionate, you know, I'm creative. I'm just loving all the emotions that I've been feeling. I'm learning to love that about myself instead of, you know, being afraid to experience these emotions or being afraid to let them out. I now learn to love them. I now learn to love my emotions. I now have learned to let them pass because they are what helped me grow, you know? Patience. Patience provides clarity. Had I been rushing or had I been, you know, fiddling and just doing stuff to consume my time instead of sitting there and letting the things come to me that I need and letting the things come to me that I truly seek, I would have been lost in the sauce. During these past couple months, I was able to rid myself of a lot of things that I didn't need. Because during that downtime, I had to exercise my patience because, like I said, I knew that I had a plan. I knew that I was on my way somewhere, but I didn't know where. So me executing the patience that I had been, you know, practicing, it provided me with clarity on the steps that I need to take to grow, you know. Balance. Like I said, in the beginning of the year, I was on my A game, you know, my diet, my meditating, reading, all of that. I was on it heavy. Summer came, I started to become distracted. I started to, you know, just push the things that I needed to be doing away. I didn't have balance. I didn't. Now I feel like I'm regaining it, and now I'm gonna make sure I keep it, because now that I know that I'm on my path, I cannot let anything distort me. I have to know when enough is enough, and I have to know when too little is too little, you know? Faith. I lost faith. And faith is self-love, you know? I lost hope within myself. I didn't believe in myself. But now I'm gaining that back. In order for me to remain on the path that I'm going, I have to keep faith. I have to believe. Because if I don't believe, who will? If I don't believe in me, who will? If I don't believe in this life that I'm meant to live, who will? You know? Faith. It's so important. It's essential in growing. You have to have faith. You have to see. You have to be able to feel that good things are coming. You have to believe in yourself. You have to have that allegiance to yourself. Even though there is no proof where you are headed, you have to just remain hopeful in order to make it, you know? That's the importance of solitude, is restoring and rebuilding within yourself. Because nobody is gonna do that for you but you. So you guys, this is the end of the interactive corner. I plan on seeing you all in the active corner where we getting physical next time, baby. I plan on bringing back some of these same guests, but even new guests. Like for our food segments, I plan on cooking. I can't express too much to you guys right now. But just have faith in me, you guys. Believe in me. Believe in yourselves, too, while I'm not here. And since I am going to be gone for a little while, get with me on Instagram. Get with me on Twitter. Good Girl Les. G-O-O-D-G-I-R-L-L-E-S. It's the same one, both. Love you guys. Until again.